subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Colonizing another cosmic body, be it the Moon or Mars, is the next frontier in the field of space exploration. But one of the main challenges of long-term space flight is the detrimental effect on the human body. Humans have evolved over thousands of years to survive on a planet with gravity, and the absence of it interferes with how our body functions. Blood circulation and muscle health are some of the key aspects of our health that get impacted in space, while some astronauts have also suffered from vision problems. Now, a team working with NASA has designed a high-tech sleeping bag that could solve vision issues in space. In this video, I talk about sealed vacuum-equipped sleeping bag, how it works, and why it may be necessary in long-term space journeys. I am Mohana Basu, and this is Pure Science. In the absence of gravity, when astronauts try to sleep, bodily fluids can float into the head and continually push and reshape the back of the eyeball. The phenomenon has vexed scientists for more than a decade and remains one of the biggest health dilemmas of human space exploration. The new sleeping bag pulls down bodily fluids that naturally float into the head of an astronaut while a person is in supine position. The team found that while just 3 days of lying flat induced enough pressure to alter the eyeball's shape, no such change occurred when the suction technology was used. NASA hopes that the sleeping bag can address a disorder called spaceflight-associated neuroocular syndrome, or SANS. The condition is characterized by progressive flattening of the eyeball, swelling of the optic nerve, and vision impairment. Previous studies by the scientific team have shown that the condition is caused by constant pressure that body fluids apply to the brain. On Earth, gravity pulls fluids down into the body each time a person gets out of bed, which is why SANS is not witnessed on Earth. But in space, the lack of gravity prevents this daily unloading process, allowing more than half of a gallon of body fluid to gather in the head and apply pressure to the eyeball. NASA has documented vision problems in more than half of the astronauts who served for at least 6 months on the International Space Station. Some became farsighted and had difficulty reading, and sometimes needed crewmates to assist them in experiments. So far, the best remedy has been the use of special space glasses with adjustable lenses that correct astronauts' changing vision aboard the space station. However, this does little to alleviate concerns about the long-term effects on the eyeball. Moreover, researchers have also found cardiovascular complications among astronauts who spend long durations in space. A 2018 study, for example, showed that spending 6 months in zero gravity may increase the odds of developing a common heart arrhythmia called atrial fibrillation. This condition can lead to blood clots, heart attacks, or stroke. It is also possible that the full range of possible effects of brain pressure on human health have not been documented yet. Some astronauts also report something they call the space stupids, that is, they make more mistakes than they think they should. It is not yet known whether that has anything to do with the inability to maintain the brain pressure. Although some effects of SANS appear temporary, vision returns to normal shortly after astronauts return to Earth. The new research is vital to the manned Mars flight that NASA hopes to launch in the next decade. The sleeping bag technology, in particular, could address both the brain and heart issues. The sleeping bag prototype is the culmination of several phases of research conducted by University of Texas Southwestern in the US to help NASA better understand the disorder, including a 2017 study that provided compelling evidence that constant pressure may indeed contribute to SANS. To test this theory on brain pressure, researchers recruited cancer survivors from across the US who still had ports on their head where they had received chemotherapy. These pots offered researchers rare access to measure pressure directly in the brain. The volunteers each went on a zero-gravity airplane flight into the upper atmosphere where their body fluids floated upward. A neurosurgeon then measured the brain pressure by inserting special equipment into the pot. Wendy Hancock, a leukemia survivor from Philadelphia who volunteered for the study, agreed to go on more than 36 up and down maneuvers into zero gravity. Hancock said that this was hard, but she was happy to do it for a chance to help astronauts. The resulting study showed that brain pressure in a person who lies down on Earth is actually higher than in space. However, on Earth, the pressure is unloaded when the person stands up and gravity pulls the fluids down. But the space provides no such relief for astronauts. Equipped with this information, the team started to develop a high-tech sleeping bag that could be used by astronauts each night to unload pressure in the brain. Although similar lower body negative pressure technology has been used for decades to maintain muscle and bone mass in space, previous prototypes were not designed for many hours of use or tested as an antidote for SANS. The bag has a solid frame and is designed to fit over a person from waist down. Several questions still need to be answered before NASA brings the technology aboard the space station, including the optimal amount of time that astronauts should spend in the sleeping bag each day. However, the team's latest findings indicate that SANS won't be a health risk by the time the space agency is ready to launch to the Red Planet. This is Mohana Basu, special correspondent at The Print. If you like our videos, you can now join The Print's YouTube membership to get special membership perks such as early access to our key reports as well as exclusive community content on the YouTube channel. You can do so through the link in the description box below.